गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, 12th स्टैंडर्ड फिजिक्स. सो इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ बाय चेंजिंग द एरिया ऑफ द कॉइल. सो कंसीडर ए मेटालिक फ्रेम सो दैट एबी इज अ मूवेबल रॉड दैट इज लेंथ एल. सो द एबी इज मूव्ड टुवर्ड्स सीडी. सो दैट मेटालिक फ्रेम इज प्लेस्ड इन अ यूनिफॉर्म मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. सो द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन. सो द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइन्स इज परपेंडिकुलर एंड ऑलवेज इनवर्स. सो दैट AB is moved towards CD, that is towards left with constant velocity V. So there is AB is moved towards DC. So the area of the metallic frame decreases as well as magnetic flux through the loop also decreases. So the change in magnetic flux equal to that magnetic field. So magnetic field also changes. Then change in area. So the change in area is small, that is DA. So that area, that is ABCD. That small area ABCD. So that area equal to L into B. So that L is the length of the rod, B is the breadth. So breadth can be written as that BC is written as VDT. So velocity equal to displacement by time. So displacement equal to velocity into time. So that velocity into time is for a small time. So for a small time, we are shifting the rod from AB to CD with velocity V. So that area ABCD equal to L into VDT. So substitute here. Instead of ABCD, so we'll get the magnetic flux, change in magnetic flux in time dt, BLV dt. So that dt is goes to denominator. So d pi by dt equal to BLV. So that induced EMF produced due to the change in area, if it is placed in a uniform magnetic flux. So that induced EMF equal to d pi by dt. So here d pi by dt equal to BLV. So that magnitude of induced EMF equal to BLV. It's the product of magnetic field, length of the rod, and what is the velocity of the rod. Then, so that loop have a resistance R. So what is the induced current? Now what is the induced current? Current I is equal to, according to Ohm's law, V is equal to IR, I is equal to V by R. So that induced EMF in terms of voltage, that is induced EMF divided by resistance. So induced EMF equal to BLV, you will get I is equal to BLV by R. So that is the current flowing through the metallic frame. Then, so that energy conservation. So here that AB, there is a current flowing through the rod. That direction of current is find out using the Fleming right hand rule. So we are moving in this direction. The current flow is also in opposite direction. That is a cause and effect. So that AB is current flowing. So current carrying conductor is placed in a uniform magnetic field perpendicular to each other. There is a force acting in opposite direction. So in this direction there is a force, that is magnetic force. So we are applying. So that is AB, there is a current flowing. So current carrying conductor is placed in a uniform magnetic field. So there is a magnetic force in this direction. It is in opposite direction. So we are applying in this direction, that is magnetic force in opposite direction. The magnetic force F is equal to IL cross B. So that length of the rod and magnetic field are in 90 degree, that is mutually perpendicular. So sin 90 equal to 1. So that magnetic force equal to ILB. Then we are applying in this direction. We are applying a force. We need to shift. We need to apply a force against the magnetic force. So the magnitude of that applied force is equal to magnitude of that magnetic force. So both are equal. Then, so beyond the magnetic force, we need to apply. Some work is done against the force. Some work is done. That is rate of doing work. So the power is equal to applied force into velocity. So we need to apply some force to maintain the constant velocity. So we need to apply a force in this direction. That is F applied force. So the magnetic force in opposite direction. So applied force is equal to that magnetic force. So both are ILB. Then some work is done. So the rate of doing work to moving the rod in from left to right. So that power is equal to force into velocity. That force is applied force. So that force and velocity in the same direction. Here force in this direction, velocity in this direction. So theta equal to 0. So cos 0 equal to 1. So F is equal to, so already you know ILB, so ILB into V, we know I. So current I in the loop, that is BLV by R. So just substitute, you will get B squared L squared V squared by R. So that is a power generated by moving the rod towards left. Then, so we are applying some mechanical energy. So we are moving the rod. That mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. There is a current flow. Then, due to the current flow in the rod AB, there is a Joule-Thomson effect. That is Joule effect. That is Joule heating effect. So that heat is, that is rate of heat is dissipated in the circuit. So power is equal to voltage into current. So V is equal to IR. So that is I squared R. So V is equal to IR. Power equal to voltage into current. This is a base formula. I is equal to V is equal to IR. So I. So it's I squared R. So power equal to I squared R. So I squared we know. So I is equal to BLV by R. So I squared equal to B squared L squared V squared by R squared. So multiply by R you will get B squared L squared V squared by R. So both the power, that is due to electrical energy, due to the heat energy, both are same. So the energy is conserved. So the rod is moving, we are applying some mechanical energy. So mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. Again electrical energy is converted into thermal energy in terms of heat is dissipated. So okay students, so in this class we have discussed how the EMF is produced by changing the area of the coil. So they may ask in 5 marks. It's somewhat so easy question. Just go through it.